So here we are, the third match, and that means it's singles once more, the second singles. And Kenneth Jonasson, 29 years of age, tall man, 1.85 m, that's about 6'1", world ranking of 12, four times the Dane, a medalist in the European Championships, but never the gold. And Taufik Hidayat of Indonesia, 22 years of age, 1.75 m, that's 5'9", born in Bandung, world ranking of 17. The Indonesian bronze medalist at the World Championships in Seville, lost in that semi-final to Hendrawan, his teammate, who went on to take the gold. The reason he lost, he was 7-1 up in the deciding game and he injured himself, tore an adductor muscle and had to retire from the contest. What might have been their confirmation of his background, and looking at his results so far in the campaign. In the group match, he lost at second singles to China, to China's Bao Chunlai in two straight games. And then in the first round of the knockout competition against New Zealand, he wasn't selected. But in the quarterfinal against Malaysia, he played second singles and beat Roslyn Hashim in two straight games. 15-10, 15-2. Now looking at Kenneth Jonasson, didn't play against England in the group, but did play against Japan, and he beat Sho Sasaki in two games. And then in the quarterfinal against Germany, he beat Bjorn Rapine again in two straight. Glimpse of the umpire for this match, Steve Cheng of Hong Kong. Lu Daidi will be the service judge. Goes round the arena.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my left, Denmark, represented by Kenneth Jonasson. On my right, Indonesia, represented by Taufik Hidayat. Indonesia to serve, the ball, the leg.
Indonesia nearest to us as we look down on the court.
Service over,
and immediately a winning smash from Jonasson. The Dane has a slightly higher ranking, number 12 as opposed to number 17 to the Indonesian, but do you really regard him as favourite for this?
No, I watched Hidayat play the Malaysian Roslyn Hashim and he was superb, one of the best performances I've ever seen him play, just like he was doing there, attacking, unbelievable, great angles, and at the moment he's definitely my favourite to win this game.
Well. Of course, these two players have met each other once previously, but that was 4 years ago in the All England Championships. Hidayat won on that occasion, 15-5, 15-11.
Service over. Love two.
Kenneth Jonasson, former royal foot guard to Queen Margrethe II. Stuttgarter Amalienborg, the royal palace in the centre of Copenhagen.
Loose block from Kennett there. Telford so quick onto the net. This is what he's doing so well the other night, smashing. But look how quick he reaches the net. Fantastic, a very confident start from him. This time, himself getting to the net, he needs to get off the mark though. To choose which way he wanted to go.
Well, Kenneth Donison trying what you suggested, Darren, which is lifting off the smash, but so desperately difficult to get a good length on that.
I mean, Kenneth is regarded as got one of the best defences, but at the moment it's just been torn apart.
Off the mark at last.
Yeah, he done well, but my word, he had to work hard to get there.
Not that he's afraid of hard work, Kenneth Jonasson, one of the fittest players on the circuit. He doesn't quite have the same sort of explosive dynamic, speed and power around the court as some of the top Asian players. himself in position to hit a yard. And watch the shuttle here, it's going to drop long.
Smash from Kennett, a lot of aggression. It's what he needs to do, get a few more points, settle down his nerves, try and get himself into a rhythm. Not a lot Kennett could do about that. Good length, high serve, but up to Alfie
Quinn.
Beautiful cross-court smash, hitting the line.
Get into a flat game with the Indonesian.
No, you're right, Joe Taufik loves to play flat. Very impressed with him at the moment. Keeps his patience, but as soon as he gets the one open, takes his chance.
Yeah. Well, how many times do you think that rally was won? Goodness me, even the trick shots.
1-10.
Hidiak, the number one seed at the Olympic Games in Sydney 2000, lost in the quarterfinal to Yu Jingpeng of China and went on to take the gold medal.
Great smash down the forehand of Kennett. So quick onto the return.
He knows as soon as he's hit the straight smash there that the reply must come back to the net and probably come back straight.
Absolutely, but he's total committed on it. A lot of people hit their smashes, wait for the return, but not Taufik, straight in there. From Kennett. Two steep smashes. Taufik doing very well so he can get his racket on them. This time Kennett coming in though. Lovely deep cross-court push.
Out.
11. Good.
Robinson pans the serve back to his opponent. Oh, that is unbelievable.
Again, playing the low serve. A good net return from Kenneth. But Hidia has to go one better, rolling it over the tape.
Service over. Service
over.
Today knows he has to play virtually a perfect shot to win the rally. And certainly on his lifts, he doesn't appear to be giving the shuttle enough height in getting it over Idiot's head. And Darren, we obviously can see that Hidiat is in great form, but is it the best form you've ever seen him in?
Yeah, I must admit, Joe, I think he's looking so positive. His attacking game, you know, at the moment, it's devastating. The way he's getting up there, people guessing which way he's going. If they get their racket to it, he's there at the net so early. Very positive, good net play. Hard to see a weakness at the moment.
Well, he's an extraordinary player. All England final when just 17 years old, reached the final again a year later, and at the age of 18, became world number one.
Lovely drive, cross court from Kennett.
Service over.
Serve is short.
14-3.
Pushed it wide.
Service over.
Johnson's only real hope in this opening game is to give himself a bit of confidence for the start of the second by playing himself in.
That's right, try and work something out that he thinks he might use for the second game.
5-14.
And actually what he's been doing the last couple of points, he's just been pushing it a little bit more into court, rather than trying to play too tight to the net. So Taufik then has to actually play something rather than react to it. At the moment he's getting a few points off it.
Jonasson. Umpire Steve Chink of Hong Kong flips the stopwatch. Only a 90-second timeout in between the first and second games. First game secured 15-5 to Taufik Hidayat against the Dane, Kenneth Jonasson.
Again, Taufik goes straight on the attack in the first rally.
And it's almost appears to me as if Kenneth Jonasson has run out of ideas despite the help from the coach.
Yeah, it must be very difficult for him. Not only is he playing Taufik on tremendous form, he's got the crowd against him.
Service over. Love two.
And interestingly, Jonasson, after he played the net kill, had a quick look at the umpire. I wasn't sure if he was going to be called for a fault or not.
What variation every time he's been coming in, pushing hard at the body of Kenneth. This time, a lovely little touch, cross court close to the net.
The Indonesian, such a relaxed, easy hitting style.
Service over.
Thank you. were talking about, Darren.
Absolutely brilliant. Bennett does well to get it back. Holds the middle of the court, expecting a push. Again comes a solid little shot.
Of the head from Jonasson. Down the line, that
six,
time
love.
Bearing it once more for the block shot.
Yeah, totally dictating the game, full of confidence at the moment.
And he's already raced to a 6-love lead in the second game.
Yeah, well played from Kenneth. It's the first time he's got across and managed to whip one cross court. Telford still coming in for the strike kill there. Give Kenneth some confidence. He's been able to get the last few attacks from Telford back, and at the end of it, Telford hit in the net. We didn't see that at all in the first game. The first few errors creeping in.
Points for the Dane. Made such a psychological difference to the scoreline. Oh. Sublime.
7-3.
Absolutely fantastic reception from Telford. Leaving Kenneth absolutely stranded in the court.
just sensing that little bit of pressure, those three quick points to Denmark. And Telfik Hidiat has suddenly piled on the pressure again. Once more, have a six-point cushion.
From Telfik. Up he went his forehand corner. This time smashing strike just into the tram lines. Missed the last one. This time took his margin of error in the court, making no mistake with a smash. Great play from Kennett there. He's been driving that shot from his forehand down the line. This time takes the weight off it. Lovely, delicate cross-court drop. For the first time, out-footing Telfik.
Sam's over.
And the day. Probably clearly around the end.
9-4.
Return of serve.
4-9.
And after virtually every rally, the court having to have some attention. Of course, the shirts that the players wear absolutely sodden with perspiration. Down from that onto the court surface.
5-9.
Yeah, well played from Kennett. Pushed the serve a little bit deeper in. Got the return he wanted.
So right, as soon as Jonasson gives his opponent the angles to play with by lifting wide, then he's in all sorts of trouble.
Yeah, you can see he was annoyed with himself after that rally. Shot from Telfik again. Kennett moving to the back, trying to contain his attack.
Seven is over. 5-10.
Well, Knut Jonasson has learned from previous experience early on in this match and was standing back waiting for the attacking play from the net.
From Kennett, got a short lift, played a lovely spinning net shot, up it came, good smash down the backhand side. Yes, definitely wide. Kennett sent sprawling again, trying to get it back. This time Cowper's missing the line. He's having a lot of success with this low serve. Yeah, he's hanging on in there and he's now trying to make a little impact himself into the game.
Yes, the block's back to the net. To the centre of the court can narrow down the angle that Kiriak can hit.
Yeah, exactly. He's not trying to play too tight. He's just giving it a little push. Fantastic defence from Kennett. Under all sorts of pressure, Telford still coming in, manages to get a great lift over his head. Nothing Telford can do but get his racket on it.
That's 1 point in it now. By lifting up the centre of the court. Still, Taufik Hidayat managing to find a winning smash.
Into the backhand corner of Telford. Telford trying to dig it out.
Well, Jonasson, known in Europe, is a great fighter on court, never gives up. And certainly in the start of this second game when he was love six adrift, I thought perhaps it was going to be all one-way traffic. But all credit to the Dane.
Good play from Kennett.
9-10.
He's pushing off the net. He's just getting it over the head, not giving him too much height. Making Townsend take it a bit later in the corners.
Sense that we're coming through such a crucial phase of the game. I think we've had six serves on this scoreline with neither player able to progress any further.
Short serve and Kennett there. Robbed it up. Well played by Kennett. He fell for that shot before, this time held his position in the centre, didn't move, got the cross court he wanted. Great finish into the body of Hidea.
Square, 10-all. Well, the flip serve now not gaining him any advantage at all.
Serve is over.
If he's going to flick, it has to be a good length. That's on nowhere near the back of the court.
Tricky, only too deceptive.
Yeah, it's such a crucial stage in the game. Very hard to play that sort of shot. A lot of pressure.
11.
Missing with those smashes in the opening game. This really has been a remarkable turnaround.
Yeah, you can see, Kenneth, in his actions after winning the rally, he's starting to believe he can win this game now.
The lead for the first time in this second game. 12-11.
Service over.
I'm not sure why he's keep persisting with a flick. The last three flick serves, he's been smashed down at him.
Jonathan, furious that he's losing his footing as he tries to move.
Yeah, you can see he keeps slipping as he's pushing off, the initial push off.
Spirit from Kenneth Jonathan.
Service over.
Fantastic play from Kenneth. He left one on the back line, hit it at the last moment. Taufik played a fantastic spinning net shot. Somehow Kenneth managed to get it up.
Thank you.
growing in confidence, preparing to take Telford on at the net.
Gifts it to his opponent.
Nowhere near as relaxed as he was earlier on.
It's wide. But once again, Jonasson says to the umpire, every time I try and move, my fingers slip on the court surface. To Denmark to level this second singles at one game all.
Game at the moment. So tense out there.
I thought on the surface, Lidiat looks remarkably relaxed.
13, 14.
From Kennett,
14,
this time Coffey and Telford's attacking at a body, committed himself to the net for the knockoff.
Another game point. And once again, well saved by the Indonesian.
Over 13-14.
lovely return from serve from Kennett.
14-13.
Spinning net shot. Got the short lift.
Third time lucky for the day. And the missed shot from Taufik Hidayat when Jonasson was on the floor. And it's one game all. He's taken the second. Desperate effort. There he was on the floor. And the Indonesian missed the open court. And so the Dane has fought his way back to take the second game. 15-13. Five-minute interval, and the players, I'm sure they will change at least the shirts, absolutely sodden with perspiration, literally wringing out the sweat into a pool on the ground. And damn, what a comeback from Love, six down. He never stopped fighting.
Absolutely fantastic play from Kennett. He did look down and out for a game and a half. He stuck in there. He fought for every shuttle, and all of a sudden what he has done is taken the edge off Taufik. He doesn't look quite as sharp as he did. He's got a few seeds of doubt in his mind, and he's got himself right back in this match.
And what an influence it could have on the outcome of the tie. Remember, one match apiece so far in this Thomas Cup semi-final. Indonesia took the opening rubber in the form of Sonny D. Kinkoro against Peter Gaeta. 15-4, 15-8, very decisive match indeed. And then Denmark hit back with the first doubles with the reigning world champions Lars Borska and Jonas Rasmussen, beating Flandy, Limpele and Aung Kyaw. Out of controversial selection, because of course that particular Indonesian pairing, and the second ranked Indonesian pairing on the world ranking list.
Final game. Level play.
Third and deciding game. interesting opening rally.
Tough rally to start with. Both players not preparing to smash.
Worked the rally well, outmaneuvered Jonathan.
Yeah, it took him a long while to keep his patience. It's exactly what he did. Waited for his opening. Finally, when it came, finished it no problem with a great smash down the line. Good pick up from Kennett. Done well to get his racket to the smash. Kidiak coming for the kill, not quite as confident as he did early on.
Service over.
Well, you simply cannot afford unforced errors on serve at this level. I guess, Darren, when players get a little bit fatigued, it's the touch shots that go first.
That's right, not quite as sharp as you are in the mind early on. As you see from Taufik already, although he's got this little lead, he's still at the net, he's making these errors. I think that's where Kennett's got to try and exploit him a little bit.
Was such a tough rally, and Darren, I just wonder whether Falko Kidiat has been instructed to try and just tar his opponent out, move him from corner to corner, because it certainly seems to be working. Jonathan gradually getting slower in that rally.
Yeah, grueling rally. obviously Telford used to the humidity more than Kennett, but as you say, he's come out Telford, he's not looking to use his power so much, he's just looking to play rallies and move Kennett the distances. He might have lost that one, but in the long run, that might be the plan.
Nothing.
Retrieving from Jonasson initially on in that rally.
Again, Kennett on the floor.
Still total commitment at the net from Hidayat.
Service over.
Well, I'm not sure Hidayat liked the call.
No, he had a good look at the linesman there. Encouraging signs for Kennett. Two fairly easy mistakes from Telford.
Of the court seems to be some sort of power failure to the scoreboards, no longer showing the score.
3-2.
Hidayat, and that's what he was doing so well in the opening game.
Yeah, pushing Kennett all round the court on that rally.
5-2.
Finally got the lift he was looking for. Good smash down the line for the winner.
5-2 in this deciding game. From the net, from the Dane, just not high enough and deep enough.
6-2.
He's done it again, exactly the same shot.
Yeah, he's starting to pick his spot now. Kennett reacting not the same as he was at the end of the second.
7-2. Kuniak.
Pushed it wide. And therefore, Celtic Hidayat change ends with the advantage. And it's 8-2 in the deciding game. And the glum faces of the Danish coaching staff tell their own story. Their man is in desperate trouble here. But let's not forget that this man, Kenneth Jonasson, was 6 points adrift at the beginning of the second game, 6-1, before he fought his way back to take it 15-13.
And it got such a strong fighting spirit that we know he's not going to give up. He's going to fight his way to the end of this.
Well, the scoreboards, electricity has been restored. We need to wait just a moment. Well, they get to the correct score. It is 8-2 in the deciding game.
8-2, play. Service over, 2-8.
Yeah, good smash from Kennett. That's what he needed. Get the serve back. He knows he won. He's going from this end.
Well, he started that run. He could a low serve.
He did it, bobbed up. He's got a very good defence, was able to control his way out, and then started to dictate the value himself.
Service over.
Low serve is short of the service line.
8-3.
Very confident that it was dropping long, but my goodness, it's long by a whisker.
Service over.
Wonderful change of pace.
Yeah, well played from Kennett there. Kept the pressure on, looked like he was going to smash the shuttle. All of a sudden, takes the weight off it. Sees Telfick crouching down in the middle.
Oh, that's
brilliant.
Desperation defence. Paying dividends.
And that's what he's got to do, he's just somehow got to get it back. Telfick thought he'd hit the winner there. Didn't bother running for it, but Kennett stuck his racket out, somehow got it back over.
Five, nine.
2 points for the Danes. question the rationale behind the flick serve earlier on, Darren, and I think you should still be questioning it.
Yeah, just towards the end of the second game, he was even serving high, which gave him more time to see it.
Once again, the defence. When he reaches the shuttle, he's now beginning to guide it into the open space. Opening game, he wasn't even getting his racket to it. Ever closer.
Yeah, similar pattern to the second game. He was down at the start, gradually clawing his way back into the game.
In fact, in the second game, he was also 9-3 down, which he was here.
Again, now he's gone for the flick serve, this time he's hit long.
9-6.
From Telfig, wrong foot in Kennett. Get it done well to get anything on it and get it over. It's another valve.
In serious physical distress.
I think when he was diving for the shuttle, I think he totally winded himself for the dive.
Yes, you're right, Darren. Holding his chest. But the backhand reaction, the backhand smash from Hidoyat was out of this world. Six, deciding game. What courage from Kenneth Donison.
Six for a net shot.
Yeah, he done very well to stand his ground there.
7-13.
To push off with the legs, change direction,
seven
and
return
the shuttle.
Oh, he's given 13. Everything he's got, Kennett, to try to get his way back in. It must be hurting out there.
Drive across court. Well, Darren, I'm sure you know, having played against Kennett Renison, what a fighter he is, and you can never count the match won until the final shuttle is hit.
Oh, absolutely, Jill. He's still out there. He's still battling on. Anything can happen at the moment.
I just sense a couple of good points, and perhaps Hidiak would start and get a little bit nervous. And then who knows?
Service over. 13-7.
Selfie, done the right things, making Kennett move on the match point.
40, that's on, 7.
This for a 2-1 lead in the tie.
This time took a chance, moved forward on the backhand drop from Telford. Exhausting.
Savare going in to the Danish
players there. 47.
Match point number 3. Jonathan can be proud of his performance, but Hidiak, a class above his opponents in the opening game, looking for 15-5. And it was the sheer guts and determination of the day that took the match the full distance. But Hidiak safely secured the second point for Indonesia. Second doubles coming up next.